Hello, my name is Álvaro Romero Calvo, and I am a PhD student at the University of Colorado Boulder. Today, I would like to welcome you to this presentation on behalf of my co-authors, where we are going to introduce our new numerical simulation framework to study the sloshing of magnetic liquids in microgravity. But first, let's go to the fundamentals. We define sloshing as the movement of liquids in partially filled tanks. Sloshing in high gravity does not suppose a big problem from the theoretical perspective because you have the strong restoring force of gravity. However, in low gravity environments, sloshing becomes highly stochastic and complicates the design of propellant tanks and the attitude control system of our spacecraft. Indeed, in order to counterbalance these effects, we usually use what is called propellant management devices. However, propellant management devices add mass, inner mass to our system and complicate numerical analysis. For this reason, in the 60s, there was a big deal of research going on trying to apply electromagnetic fields to reproduce a gravity equivalent force in space. And this resulted in two different branches. On the electric side, we have the electrophoresis, and on the magnetic side, we have what has been named as magnetic liquid position. It was at the same time when Solomon Steve Pavel invented ferrofluids to enhance the magnetic properties of liquids in low gravity. All these works have continued until nowadays. You can see, for instance, the efforts of Marchet and Winter on the study of liquid oxygen reorientation in low gravity, or our own works in magnetic liquid sloshing, which is an evolution of this previous research. However, all these previous works usually decoupled or commonly decouple the magnetic and fluid problems. But if you are using a highly concentrated ferrofluid, that is not possible because the shape the shape and position of your liquid actually influence the magnetic fields to which it is subjected. And that's why we developed this quasi-analytical model that you can see in the bottom of this slide. And we our goal was to obtain the sloshing frequencies of a magnetic system, of a magnetic liquid, of a magnetic free surface, and study those frequencies as a function of the applied magnetic field. We soon discovered that we needed coupled magnetic problems because of the reasons I have already explained, and that we needed more complex numerical simulation frameworks to study advanced parameters such as the stability of the surface. And that's actually what motivates this work. So let's formulate the problem first of all. We have an incompressible viscous Newtonian magnetic liquid that is located in a container that we are going to assume cylindrical for now in resemblance to the ESAT Roger Thesis 2017 experiment. We are going to consider an inhomogeneous magnetic field generated by either a coil or a magnet, or both of them. And our desired outputs are the asymmetric meniscus profile, free surface oscillation frequencies, surface stability properties, and also the time-dependent evolution of the system. So, first of all, what is our numerical approach? If we assume a coupled fluid magnetic problem with a monolithic solution scheme, that means that we solve all our equations simultaneously. And our equations are basically Navier-Stokes for the fluid side and Maxwell steady-state Maxwell equations for the magnetic side. So, the thing is that these two systems of equations are coupled by means of a magnetic term that is implemented in the momentum conservation equation, and also by the pressure term, but that's a second order effect. However, as I said before, the shape of the liquid influences the boundary conditions of the steady state Maxwell equations. And so this is a closed loop that can only be broken when you consider low susceptibility magnetic liquids, such as liquid oxygen or even water. So if you have highly susceptible liquids such as ferrofluid, you need a coupled simulation approach. You can see, by the way, all these expressions in the frame, cylindrical frame that we actually employed in our model, in our paper. So you're invited to read it if you need more information. One of the interesting things of our model is the discretization strategy that we follow. So regions A, B, and C, where A denotes the liquid, B the rest of the container, and C the airspace above it, they are discretized by a non-singular mapping to a rectangular domain. So we express all of our equations in that mapped rectangular domain. Region D, on the contrary, follows a mesh-free approach because we needed geometrical flexibility to accommodate different magnets and coils. We compute or select our points with a two-dimensional Delaunay mesh generator, and we compute the collocation matrices of our system with a moving least squares algorithm. One interesting thing here is that in order to select the neighbors of each node for the mesh-free approach, we adopt a different strategy depending on where the node is located. So if it is an interior node, we just select the nodes surrounding it. If it is in the wall, as you can see here in the middle, we select the nodes in the interior of the domain. And if it is in the corner, we follow more or less the same approach as if we are in the interior. This results in a better conditioning of the collocation matrices used in our system. Finally, for region E, we choose a rectangular mesh, but if we don't have a rectangular shape, we can always use a non-singular mapping. This discretized system of equations is solved with a monolithic fully implicit Newton-Raphson approach. And the fact that it is fully implicit allows us to compute the steady state solution in a single time step, which is extremely computationally efficient. Now, since this model has already been validated with measurements taken at the International Space Station and with many other problems, we focus our verification in the magnetic side of the system. So here you can see the magnetic field H compared with an equivalent simulation in console multiphysics, and you can see they are practically identical. The same happens with the magnetization field inside the ferrofluid domain. And this result gives us confidence that the system is working properly, at least the magnetic system is working properly. The magnetic force is computed as a function of the gradient of the field H, and hence is very useful to denote or to reveal numerical instabilities in the system, and that's exactly what you can see here in this region, where you can see these knots in the side in the contact with region D. This is telling us that the conditioning of our nodes in region D is not as good as we would like to, even if this is a common problem in numerical simulation, as you can see in this equivalent console multiphysics map. And even if our system is far more robust to this than the equivalent console multiphysics model, we still need to solve these issues, these numerical issues, to compute strong magnetic fields. We need strong magnetic fields to compare the meniscus profile in the steady state, because strong magnetic fields induce a large modification of the meniscus or a large deformation. And so they are perfect for validating our model or verifying our model, better said, with previous quasi-asymmetric models. Finally, we test the implementation of the magnetic terms in the momentum equation by noting that during the steady state and for linear liquids, the magnetic field lines have to be parallel to the pressure lines, which is a feature that we can clearly observe in this picture. So we have verified the magnetic model of the system and the magnetic implementation of these forces in the momentum balance. So to conclude this presentation, we have developed a coupled magnetohydrodynamic model to study magnetic liquid sloshing. This has never been done before. It is an extremely complex problem. We have also verified the steady state solution, that is the shape of the meniscus and the magnetic side of the model. But the conditioning of the region D is still not good enough to test strong magnetic fields, and we are working on solving this problem. Our next steps involve solving the oscillation problem, or the linearized oscillation problem, that is computing the oscillation frequencies of the system and validate them with measurements collected by our team in the past at SAMS Tower in Bremen. We also want to study the stability of a magnetic meniscus subjected to different loads. And this is very important to ensure that we can actually hold our liquid in space. We want to study the liquid reorientation of magnetic liquids for magnetic propellant positioning applications, and study the influence of magnetically induced viscosity. Finally, we want to extend these to lateral oscillations and apply this model to different attitude dynamics problems. So this was all from us for today. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us at any of the links that you can see in this slide. Thank you for attending this presentation.